Peace and Black Power family. So today I'm going to touch on the usage of culture. What is culture and how should we use culture, right? By definition, culture is supposed to solve the problems of a people, right? And when this culture no longer solves the problem of a people, you must alter aspects of that culture or change the culture altogether. One of the problems that I see in our community is that we find an African culture and we hold tight to it, right? When you look at a lot of these Egyptologist dudes, right? These dudes who stuck in ancient Kemet. They just can't get their head out of ancient Kemet. Everything is about an Unk. Everything is about Egypt. Just everything is stuck on Egypt, right? And they haven't yet learned how to modify that information that they're using. Culture should not stay the same. Culture should be always evolving. If we look at the culture of white supremacy, right? It's always evolving. First, it enslaves you. Then it segregates you. Then it brings you back into the society. Like, it's always changing. If white supremacy would stay the same, then we would have figured out a way to defeat it long time ago, right? But they realize if the culture of white supremacy must stay alive, they must always alter it. We try to hold on to African culture or African culture or anything in general. We hold on to it and say, that's just all I know, and that's just my culture. No, we have to understand that if we want to be prosperous, if we want to defeat white supremacy, we must learn how to alter our cultures. I'll give you a prime example. People often get on me a lot because I sort of support the idea of polygamy, right? And I say sort of because not all Africans can practice polygamy because all of us ain't truly African in our core. Let me just say that. But people get on me about that. Oh, Brother Hassan, how can you support polygamy? Polygamy doesn't have to be something that's generational. Polygamy doesn't have to be something that's practiced 30, 40 generations down the line. Polygamy can be practiced for one generation to correct the problem that we have within our community. Let me explain to you. We have a shortage of homes of black men, right? We understand that black women outnumber men in this system, and also a huge percentage of black men are incarcerated, right? So enacting and practicing, right, polygamy for one generation that can offset the problem of broken black families, and that can create a whole bunch of strong black men and strong black families from that dynamic. Just practicing it for one generation to correct the mass incarceration of black men, to correct the death toll of black men, right? But a lot of us, we don't want to sacrifice through that. We don't want to go through one generation of practicing polygamy because we feel like, I don't want to share my man. Or, you know what I'm saying? Like, we have this Eurocentric mentality, right? But again, polygamy doesn't have to be something that's five generational down the line. It can be done in one generation to correct and offset the broken black families that we do have, right? Because that's what culture is. Culture is supposed to fulfill the needs of a people. You just don't get an African culture. You just don't hold on to an African culture just because it's African. Because the problems that they faced back then, we may not face today. For example, I have on kente cloth, right? We're just now getting into the Afrocentric kente cloth, right? One of our problems is economics. So let's say, for example, we want to start, everybody start wearing kente cloth. But we realize that, wait a minute, the Europeans have a monopoly on kente cloth. You know what I'm saying? It's not going to really benefit us. We're going to stop buying kente cloth, but we're going to buy it through a third party because the European has a monopoly on it, right? So what do? We change our African culture and say, now everybody should start wearing red, black, and green tie-dye shirts. And we sell those in our community, right? Because there's nothing sacred about, and shout out to my brother Cam for the red, black, and green, you know what I'm saying? Let me shout out to that brother, red, black, and green, you know, tie-dye. If you ain't got one, get you one, you feel me? But so culture is supposed to fit our needs. It's supposed to, nothing is sacred about culture. Our ancestors came up with these cultural ideas out of a need to fit a social dynamic or a social crisis that they were going through, right? Culture comes out of the existence of people. Culture wouldn't exist without people. We create the culture. We create the culture. right? So we must create a culture that's beneficial to us. Just don't hold on to Haitian culture because it's Haitian culture. Just don't hold on to African-American culture because it's African culture. Just don't hold on to Nigerian culture because it's Nigerian culture. See how it benefits. What can we take from that culture? And how can we use it in our best interests? But just holding on to culture just because it's culture is ridiculous. It's utterly ridiculous. And you would die holding on to your culture. You would die holding on to your idealistic, you know what I'm saying, viewpoints of your culture. You will die doing that. We must modify our culture. I'm not saying that we should forget about our African culture. I'm not saying that we should not practice our African cultures, but we must modify them where they fit us and they fit our needs in this modern era, okay? Just putting on unks and building pyramids and all that stuff, that ain't going to do nothing for us. That ain't going to do nothing for us. So until next time, family, thank you for joining me. Until next time, think black, stay black, love black, support black. And that's real African black power. Wait, where am I ringing at? Oh, well.